Hey, what is up everyone, and welcome back to Play the Game. It is an exciting time for Zombies fans as Season 2 has just come, and with it an all new Battle Pass, two new weapons, both weapon and operator skins, and of course the Outbreak event. Now to start us off, let's have a quick look at the Battle Pass and what it has to offer us this season. Now something of note is that the theme of the pass is Southeast Asia, specifically the Golden Triangle, the area which borders Thailand, Laos, and Myanmar. This pass of course has 100 tiers, but we will only be looking at the high value legendary weapons. First up at tier 15 is our first new weapon of the season. It is the FARA 83 or FAA 81. It was mostly inspired by the Israeli IMI Galil. Now the FARA is an Argentinian made rifle chambered in 5.56 by 45mm with a 30 round mag, great for mid to long range engagements. At tier 27 is the MP5 First Mate. It's a very nice design with a tri-sword coat of arms on the grip with the initials BS. On the receiver, we see the number 925 as well as what looks like a king's crown, a lion, and the letter L. Next up at tier 31 is the second new weapon of the pass, the LC-10. Now I have seen no references to what this gun can equate to in the real world, but it bolsters a large 34 round magazine as well as a high rate of fire, which is perfect for short engagements. At tier 42, we hit a very nice looking Colt 1911 Midnight, fitting since every outfit of the gun is coated in pitch black. The description is that it is designed to go under the radar for nighttime use. Tier 55 brings us an insane looking KSP-45 Dragon Idol, embroidered with green and gold dragons from front to back and a 48 round extended ammo box attachment. We have a double feature at tiers 64 and 65, with a very nice looking evil hellhound calling card, followed by the AUG Emerald Archer. It's not my favorite of the lot, and it's very minimalistic and looks more just like standard jungle camo. At tier 71 is probably one of my favorite camos in this pass, the Krig 6 Samurai's Creed. Gold and white with the depiction of a fallen samurai warrior, surrounded by trees, shrines, and laying in front of the sun. Next up at tier 76 is quite literally short and sweet, the Hauer 77 Rat Hole, just a commando rat with a flashlight and a revolver. At 81, we have the AK-47 Almost Ripe, a nice visual pun based off of the banana mag of the AK-47 with a sticker that says Papua, referencing Papua New Guinea's bananas and Chiquita banana brand. Number 10 and tier 85 brings us the M16 Ranger Elite with an incredibly long 20.5-inch stock painted in the colors and branding the logo of the Vietnamese Rangers. Tier 89, we have the Pellington 703 Overtaped, and sticking to its name, it is completely covered in black tape from its body to its stock, along with two bullets taped to its side. It's a very simple design for a legendary weapon at such a later tier. Next, at tier 95, we have an ultra-rare Vulture Exo-Reactive Camo for the FARA 83. Black, with the skeleton of a vulture along the body of the gun, you can see the reactive changes at 100, 150, and 200 Z kills, getting progressively more electrified and eventually turning orange at its final stage. The final item of note in the pass is the LC-10 Poison Dart. Painted in the colors of the Poison Dart Frog, it is also covered completely in the warts that you would see on a frog or toad. Small, colorful, and deadly. And finally here, we will take a look at the Outbreak event, which ends in now 11 days. These are missions that you can both do in Outbreak and Warzone, which only include PvE, which is just killing zombies. Now, of course, in Warzone itself, you do need to worry about getting killed, but you do not have to worry about getting kills. Now, first up, we have the Gas Mask Charm for successfully exfilling 3 times in Outbreak. Next is Aim for the Head calling card. In Warzone, kill 10 zombies with headshots. Back to Outbreak, we have the Amigos sticker for eliminating 250 zombies. In Warzone, we have Eliminate 20 zombies and get the cleaning supplies charm. The Dark Aether accessory, Watch for Outbreak for eliminating 10 elites. in Warzone, using lethal equipment to kill 8 zombies will grant you the Strange Emission Emblem. For Outbreak, we have the Grasp for Power sticker for opening 25 chests in Outbreak. We then have the Skull Survivor Emblem. In Warzone, use vehicles to eliminate 3 zombies. Pure Anguish Charm. In Outbreak, complete 3 world events such as launching dragons, hunting hordes, or opening golden chests. The Head Blazing sticker for Warzone for eliminating 5 zombies in a single match 3 times, which may be the hardest of the bunch as, like I said, you are needing to worry about other players killing you during the time that you are trying to kill zombies. If you're trying to go for zombies, you can assume that other people are as well. On the Move calling card, in Outbreak, warp 10 times. Shotgun eliminations. Use shotguns to eliminate 8 zombies and get the Shotgun Eliminations calling card. Special Eliminations calling card for killing 3 special zombies in Outbreak. In Warzone, rapidly kill 2 or more zombies 2 times for the 1-2 punch calling card. Not the Last Emblem for using vehicles to eliminate 100 zombies in Outbreak. The Immolation Emblem for Warzone using pistols to eliminate 8 zombies. Stitch Together Charm for in Outbreak completing 10 separate objectives. And finally, the Quick Elimination calling card for killing 8 zombies before the first circle closes. And that will be all for it today. Of course, if you haven't already, please give the video a like, subscribe to the channel, and make sure you follow us on the Play the Game Twitch, as well as joining the Play the Game Discord. And we will see you all in the next one.